Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Mariah and I am from Junk Journal Addict. Today I want to share with you day 12, I believe, from the 100 day project. I have so many of these, how do you say that, pictures. They're all from Tim Holtz. And I thought I want to make some mini journals. So what do you have to use? These paper dolls. I'm gonna grab some leather, this one, then some paper. I have here some little pieces, and I will grab some other leftovers. Very big box with lots of paper, so I'm going to use this one and maybe some that and this. Sorry for that. And some plain paper. Okay. That's the paper I will be using. First, I'm gonna cut my letter. Let me take a look if you all seeing that. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, and then how big it's going to be, this size, and think about here, so it have to be 7 centimeters, yeah, and okay. That one, and this is 2, this is 3, this is 7 centimeters. Then I have to know where are my scissors. Oh yeah. How wide it's going to be. First, I'm gonna cut this straight. Here. Something like this, and does it work? Maybe more. Yeah, let's do this. Okay, and how many centimeters are these? 10.5. And we'll get 2 of them, yes. 10.5. Yep. Oh. Okay, then first cut it straight, 10.5, and 10.5, Okay. Now I have 2, 4, 6, 7 blah 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 blah, 7 pieces of leather, and now I'm going to decide which photos I'm going to use for the font. I think this one, this, let me clean my desk, put this aside, and maybe we will put some frosted, distress frosted crystal over it. I'm grabbing my distress embossing rubber and some paper, some plain cupping paper. Just place some distress embossing rubber over it. And place the crystal over it. Okay. Just tapping on the back to remove all the excesses. Okay. The next 4. You have to heat the frosted crystal, but don't heat it too long because then the effect is gone. So I'm gonna grab my embossing gun. Just don't heat it too long. So, and then you get this as result. I think I'm heated this too long, but normally you get this dreamy look. I hope you can see it. And yeah, this one, I think I'm heating it too long. And here you can also see it. Oh, focus please. I hope you can. You have to do it just long enough to change the color, but sometimes it's very hard. And I'm thinking that this one is not getting it, so I will do this another time. Oh, another time now again. I'm going to heat it. Yes, now it's better. Do you see it? I hope you will. Okay. Now we are going to distress. Oh, let me grab this. Where's my distress tool? Distress all of the edges with ground espresso distress oxide. place the picture at the letter. And we have to make a hole in the middle of the letter for the elastic. So I think I'm going to put here a little mark, and maybe we can do it twice. I think I'm going to grab my big crocodile. Okay. Yeah, this one. Okay. We have a hole. Yay! Over there. Let's do two at a time, or shall we try three at a time? Yes, that works also, I think. Now we are going to attach the photos. So I place some glue at the back. Place it down, and then I will stitch all around it. So I have stitched all my photos on the letter. Now I'm grabbing my stamps. I want to do some stamping at the back. So, and I will be using, what shall I do? Normally you have to use another type of ink. Let me see if I can find it. And it's called Vesicraft. Let me see if this will work. It's not very bright, but that's okay. It works fine. Okay. And I'm not thinking about where I'm gonna stamp the image, because I'm going to use several of stamps. So okay. Maybe the tree. Oh, crap. So, and these little booklets are also great for my Happy Meal. So that's why I'm making more than one. And I will keep one for myself to attach it to my big journal. Okay. Do we need some stamping at the front? Maybe will that work? I will take a look. This one I put it aside. Where's my wet? Over here. Versafine Crimson Wet. And I will take a look if this is going to work. Yeah. Okay. And maybe another stamp, then black. Where was my tag? And the Versacraft. I have to press a little bit harder. Yeah, that's better. Okay, what shall we do? Maybe I will. Will that work? If I make the corner a little bit round. Let me see if that works. No, not great. So. Maybe I can use this as a template. Okay. That's that. Now we are going to cut off all the papers that we are putting inside. Big it's going to be 10 and a half. Let's do 10. So all the papers on 10. This one and how wide? 7. So let's do 6 and a half. So I have 10, 6 and a half. Okay. First, we are going to work with this one. Okay. Just fold it in half. Do I have the more papers? I think I will. Maybe two parts together. I think it's nicer when you have a little bit thick. And And I don't mind if it's a little bit sticking out. Yeah, this is nicer. Okay, we have the middle. Where is my pen? Over here. And I'm gonna place here a mark. Okay. Hold it steady and straight. Then I will grab my crocodile and put a little knot or knot hole in it. Okay. Then just place it down. That's flat. And getting some elastic. I think this is enough. And I will do this and then to the what shall I do? So we put it over here, maybe. Do I? Yes. Okay. Then through the hole. Am I doing that right? No. You have to go from the outside to the inside. Then go back to the outside to the inside. It's a little bit wonky. So now I can see the hole. Come. Go. Come on, where's my tweezer? I can't find anything. Okay, there you are. Okay. Yeah. Then we are going. Am I doing it right? What am I doing wrong? This has to be on the inside. Why is it on the outside? I'm doing something wrong. Let me think. What if? Let me grab both ends. And I do this. Okay. Then I'm doing this. Yeah. And then a little knot. Yeah. And then you can wrap it around. Yeah, that's cool. Okay, but I want to have a closure. So we have to do it that again. And I hope that the hole is big enough. So let's put this aside. Maybe that will work. And this also. Okay, now I'm grabbing some charm. Is it too big or do I have to grab some other? What do we have? Ah, crap! I think this is working a little bit better, I think. Okay, let's do it again. Yes. Where are the ends? Over there. Okay. And over here also a little knot. So okay, now we have, I will show you. We have a little booklet. With a little charm. And maybe I will put the other strings over here. Because it's now getting in a way with the picture. But I'm not quite happy. Yeah. It will do. So this is the ID. I hope you will like it. I will make the other ones. And then I will come back to you. So see you in a bit. So welcome back. I have made already six pieces. But I've made it differently. That's why I have put the camera back on. Over here I have 4 elastic bands, but the others I have only 1, and I will show you how I have made those. First of all, let's do this. I will place the journal cover, then the paper, flip it back, make a mark so where you can put the hole in it. Over there. Then grab some elastic. Place it both sides to the hole, outside to the inside, so you get here a little bandit. And then place it to the hole from the paper. Yes, okay. Then don't pull it too hard. Fold it now and get it straight. Measure the size, pull the string. Okay. and you make a knot over here. The paper is not, how do you say that, a little bit wonky, because you only have attached it over here, but I don't mind. And then you can do this, and you have a little booklet. So I hope you will like this video. These are, come on, okay, all of the little booklets. And that one. You can follow me on my Instagram and Facebook account, Junk Journal Treasure, YouTube, of course, Junk Journal Addicts. You can buy me a coffee on my Ko-fi account, and you can find our freebies and downloads. I hope you have enjoyed this video. Please thumbs up, like the video, and it will help me to grow my little, my YouTube channel a little bit faster. So thank you. Bye bye, have a nice day.